Hachette Audio presents VIP, I'm with the Band, written by Jen Calonita, read by Tara Sands. Includes a Mac and PC compatible PDF of illustrations by Kristen Gudsnuck. For my aspiring author little cousin, Haley Ingram. Friday, February 19th. Location? Home.
I feel blue if I say I love you and you falter. Why do you turn and walk away? My heart knew the moment that I saw you, that I need you like a fish needs water.
Zander Welling was singing to me. Me! I stared happily into his big blue eyes, the same eyes that were known to make girls hyperventilate and pass out at his concerts. Wow, that smile of his was mesmerizing too. Gah, was I drooling? Drooling would ruin the moment. How often does the gorgeous lead singer of a boy band sing to you while you're running along a beach together? Wait, what was he doing now? He just stopped singing, ran a hand through his curly brown hair, and said,
Mackenzie, will you?
Stop daydreaming. My best friend Scarlett poked me hard in the cheek. You heard the DJ? Perfect Storm ticket giveaway in 5. I can't help it if I daydream about Perfect Storm. A lot. The latest was brought on by the results of the paper fortune teller our other best friend Iris made this morning. On my turn, I learned, I'm marrying Zander Welling. Yes, we're having 3 kids. Cool. We're going to live in St. Lucia. FYI, that's my favorite Caribbean island. It's also the only one Mom's taken me to. Excellent. I'm going to be an orthodontist. Wait, what? That last part had to be a mistake. Scarlett is the one who is going to be an orthodontist. She wants to invent a way for kids to benefit from braces without actually having to get braces, which sounds good to me. And I don't even need braces. Everyone knows I'm going to be an artist. Not to brag, but my friends and our art teacher, Mr. Capozzi, say I'm the best artist in 7th grade at Brookside Middle School. I'm always doodling in my journal, on the chalkboard wall in my room, or in notebooks during class. Someday, I'm going to have my own comic book series called Mac Attack. I've already started working on the first issue. It's about a girl rock band that fights crime between shows, and the lead singer is named Mac. Named after me, Mackenzie. The girls wear matching sparkly silver tank tops and pink and green camouflage pants that look cool on stage, but are comfy off stage for fighting crime. I haven't shown my first issue to anyone yet. It's top secret. But my friends have seen loads of other stuff I've drawn, like album art. That's my other dream, to design album covers. And P.S. need one for their first full-length disc. Heath Holland, one of the band members, just tweeted that their album is going to drop early next year. I was immediately inspired and drew what I think would be an amazing cover. A ship called the P.S. lost at sea in the middle of a massive storm. Get it? Scarlett and Iris say Xander, Heath, and Kyle Bayer, Perfect Storm's other member, are going to love it when I show it to them. There's just one small problem. I have to meet them first. I feel blue, I sang out loud, thinking of my awesome Xander daydream again. True PS fans know the lyrics, even though the new song hasn't been released yet. The guys put a sneak peek clip online of them singing it. Mac! Iris's brown eyes were as wild as that banshee in the way-too-scary movie we watched the other night at our sleepover. Her strawberry blonde hair looked like it had been in an electrical socket, probably because Iris had been pulling her hair out all day over these tickets.
We're supposed to be listening for the call-in sign, she said tightly. C100 is giving away only one more pair of tickets this afternoon, so stop distracting me.
Geez, this ticket business was getting to Iris. She was right, though. My Xander daydreams were for during social studies. The revolutionary what? Or car rides with Mom when she was on one of those long work calls with a client who was having what she called an identity crisis. We had to win those perfect storm tickets for tomorrow night because, to quote Scarlett, I'd rather lose my phone forever than miss seeing Perfect Storm live. Perfect Storm is worth losing your phone for. The guys in the band go together as perfectly as Nutella and frozen bananas. Zander Welling is dreamy, and we love his falsetto voice, but he's also funny and a little quirky. He's afraid of escalators. Plus, he's got a big heart. He started the Wishing You Well charity, which grants private concerts for sick kids. Is that generous or what? Scarlett says Heath Holland is the cutest because he's charming and has a killer smile like Thor, who is our favorite Avenger. But Heath's superpower is pranks. P.S.'s rebel band member has dropped water balloons on his bandmates, drawn Sharpie mustaches on Mikey G, their super intimidating bodyguard, and played practical jokes on fans with Nerf water guns. Kyle Bayer is, well, Kyle. We don't know a lot about the Brit because he's so quiet. But he's cute, he plays guitar, and he's in Perfect Storm. What's not to love? Someday, Perfect Storm is going to take over the world. But right now, a lot of people still don't know who they are. I feel sorry that those people have a Xanderless existence. They need to turn on Totally TV more often. Scarlett, Iris, and I love that channel because they play way more music videos than MTV. When Perfect Storm's EP came out, the channel named PS one of their totally awesome bands to watch. We were hooked from the moment we saw Xander sing the first line of I Could Love You Forever. I guess other girls were too, because the guy's followers doubled in a week. Now, their singles are playing on the Totally TV satellite radio station, and their YouTube channel is getting super popular thanks to some shout-outs from famous bands. According to Heath's Twitter feed, the guys have already been booked to open at 8 concerts this winter. Tomorrow, they are doing one for Z100 called Song Slam on Long Island, and that's what we're trying to get tickets for. Since the nosebleed seats at Nassau Coliseum start at $250 and none of our parents were buying the I will die if I am not at this show argument, Iris, Scarlett, and I had turned my bedroom into a Perfect Storm command center to win tickets from the radio station. So far, it wasn't going very well. Today, Z100 was giving away tickets every hour till 6 p.m., we had missed the 11 a.m. through 3 p.m. giveaways since we were in school. Mom almost burst into flames when I suggested staying home to have more chances to win. We ran home right after the last bell rang, but we lost the 4 and 5 p.m. slots. Next up was 6 o'clock, the final giveaway of the day, and we were not going to lose again. Iris had had her ear glued to the radio in my room for the last 10 minutes. Scarlett had tweeted the band all day, saying we were three broke girls trying to win tickets to make them feel bad and just give us some. And I was, daydreaming about Xander. But as soon as we heard the DJ tell people to call in, we sprang into action. Dial, 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 Scarlett screamed, sounding like Coach Riley does when she yells at us for walking the track in gym instead of running. We hit our phones like our lives depended on it. I could tell Iris was nervous because she started to sing off key and Scarlett flipped out. No singing, Scarlett screeched as her fingers kept hitting the redial button on her bedazzled cell phone. That girl is lightning fast, which works out well for the school's softball team and hopefully radio contests. Scarlett is the ace first baseman on the team. Or is that first base girl? Your voice is distracting. Scarlett can be testy when she is feeling competitive. I looked at one of my Xander posters that decorate my bedroom walls like wallpaper. Can you believe she talks to her best friends like that? I asked poster Xander. I talk to my PS posters a lot, which may sound weird, but that's what happens when you're an only child and your mom works at a big tour management firm in New York City. She used to go out on the road with some of the biggest bands in the world, But when she had me, she took a job that kept her closer to home. Technically, Mom still works a lot.
Mac, are you dialing or talking to Z again?
Iris's voice was tense, too. Her fingers pounded angrily on her phone as well, and I winced.
Yes, I'm... I heard the busy signal stop, and the phone begin to ring through.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.